17. Of course, bill was introduced in Lok Sabha on 16th March 2016 with referral to Standing Committee, and now we are actually taking Raj Sabha. And one way I am happy that amendments proposed change in definition, remove ambages, allowing greater flexibility, simplifying memorandum of association, ease of doing business with procedure simplified, appointment of auditors and continuation of auditors need to be informed. See, here I would like to say, people should not misunderstand every business company, every corporate company, everybody is cheating, it is not correct. Then no economy, country will be totally no employment, no growth of the country. So, 125 crores population, if 15-20 companies commit mistakes and so maybe fraud, whatever you may call it, you can't be, everybody is bad, everybody this thing. So definitely we have to support the economy, growth of economy, business and everything. So therefore this type of amendment welcome, but still more amendments are required in the future to actually to clarify the much more ambiguity, sir. Here one good point what I say is, independent directors, the recent Supreme Court judgment actually has given that for any liability responsibility of the company, independent director also is responsible and their family member is responsible. It's very dangerous. Supreme Court, no doubt, is a supreme judicial authority, but still Parliament is much more supreme. So Parliament, this amendment must take place that independent director should, otherwise no independent director will come to a company. The very philosophy of independent directors in the business will totally, will fail actually. So this is very important. This point is to be borne in the mind, sir. And another most important is, when the banks are giving loans for the any companies doing business, it is their response to see the security and see look after the credibility of the company and safety, security of their loan, what they are giving. But at the same time, they should not insist on the personal guarantee of the promoters. It was not there previously. Recently, because some few companies committed over business, over trading, and they got into stuck into problems, and they know they are declared as the actually cheaters, which may not, I won't agree. If a company which is in bad shape is not a cheater. This is because circumstances. Sometimes industry may fail. So system, for example, take the power sector. In the power sector, thermal power sector, when there was privatization taken place by the government of India about 15 years back, in the country, everybody was in a queue to start the thermal power companies. And everybody borrowed money. When they started construction projects, suddenly this demand disappeared. They went to the actually the other concern, the hydro and also in the new system, this commercial energy, non-thermal energy. So with this, thermal power all collapsed. Then all the people who have borrowed money from the banks, they are in a very, very bad shape. Doesn't mean they have cheated. Therefore, I would like to classify people who are got stuck due to circumstances and who are in trouble and troubling banks also one section. Some section who was also willful defaulters, willfully they also siphoned money, that may be very little section. So we have to bear in mind that also, and we must see that banks should not insist on the promoters to give the personal guarantees. Then another last point, what I would like to say, most important is, when the promoters are running the company, see, a company is formed with the promoters, and also other directors also will be there. But is the promoter responsibility to see company goes smoothly. Sometimes promoters may give their personal properties also security to the banks. So therefore, there is nothing wrong with promoter also borrow some money from the banks, from the companies. And company also gives money to the promoter. Promoter gives to the company, nothing wrong. The restriction should go. Now I'm happy that this amendment, there is a proposal that yes, with a special resolution of the any board, they can allow the promoters also to borrow money, which is a very welcome factor, I must say. Then lastly, I must also appreciate the provisions relating to forward dealing with insider trading to be omitted from the Act. The requirement of approval of central government for magistrate remuneration above the prescribed limits to be replaced by the approval through the special resolution by shareholders is also a welcome thing, sir. And also I would say, company may give loans to entities in which directors are interested, either passing special resolution, as I told already, this is also very, last 1.5 minutes, last. And also I say, remove the restrictions on layers of subsidiaries and investment companies, allow for exempting class of foreign companies from registered and compliance regime under Act. These are all welcome factors. So in conclusion, I say, this is the actually united effort of every political party and every citizen of the country to make the country's business grow and economy grow and employment grow. It's all interlinked. We should not mistake that just because some companies are taking away money, it's not correct. Therefore, all amendments are welcome, and some more amendments also required. Perhaps next year, after taking some more actually representation, the guidance and all details, we must go for again further also amendments future. Thank you.